about the off season is that when the basketball season's over, when we play our final game, hopefully this year in the NCAA tournament, that we're finished for the year and everybody goes on vacation and that's it. And a coach's life changes from a day-to-day aspect of what you're doing in the off season. But you don't go to the beach, you don't stop coming to the office. As soon as the season's over, we go into postseason workouts, which we can do up until, I believe, the week before finals. Now, the NCAA changed a rule a couple of years ago where now kids can work out in the summer if they're taking classes. So most of our guys went home for a few weeks during summer A. The entire team was back during summer B, and we started summer workouts, which is a great way for the younger guys, the freshmen and transfers, to really get acclimated to campus and also get used to what we do on the floor. It lets the older guys get to know them kind of individually and also teach them, hey, this is how we do things at FGCU.
First day workout, man, we got out there. I was kind of tired a little bit, but, you know, it's the first day, man. You know, you're trying to get back in the swing of things. You know, we got a lot of shots, so it was good, man. A little tired, but took a nap.
Oh, boy. That's all I gotta say.
We just finished playing a 5-on-5 game, you know, with a few of the students here. You know, they wanted to see what it was like to, you know, play the basketball team. As you know, we stomped them out, you know, 101, that was a score. We really leave no mercy out there, you know, for all competitors.
Get Chase, pop it, damn. Hold on,
I mean, the reality of it is, we actually have pretty much a new team. You know, with the additions to Dream the Bulls, Brian Green, Mark Eddy, Christian Terrell, Zach Johnson, Demetrius Morant, you know, Eric Mulder. That's seven guys that half were here, half weren't. None of them have played a game here yet. Guys came in this summer and they worked and they competed. They got after it a little bit. And I think the foundation of how we have to work around here was good to have Brett, Bernard, Jamel, you know, to see how Nate Hicks has recovered since his surgery. After the Florida State game and how he's bounced back so quickly just over the summer going into boot camp, those guys have had the experience to see those senior leaders work.
Boot camp, early in the morning, man. See, I'm the first one in here, you know, locker room. I'm trying to wait on my teammates, man. We about to get it going. Last boot camp, man, senior year, man. We got to get it cracking.
I think all in all, our second boot camp went very well. I think we were able to get in a lot of conditioning. We were able to get a lot of defensive concepts. And I think our guys adapted very well. It's a great opportunity for them not to have a whole preseason running program, and it allows us to get great conditioning in order to be able to practice. I think going into the season, I think that the guys want to have some basketball legs. I think we were able to do that. A lot of our defensive concepts were shown, and I think the guys picked it up. It's good because a lot of them were here last year. I think it's a great concept. You know, we picked it up from Coach Self at Kansas, and it allows us to get our guys some toughness and resiliency.
The good thing is you guys see, you can run all day. I mean, you guys, think about it. By next week, we'll easily go 40 for 40. Okay, we did 20 for 20 today. As you ease into it, I look at Mueller. You see, you're beat already. I said 40 for 40, your head goes down automatically.
Already beat.
I was just thinking, oh my, you guys knew whatever you wanted to do. Mark, was that hard?
That's what happens, man. You see that right there?
Boot camp 2014, man. I got battle wounds, man.
You know what I'm saying?
Work hard, play hard, work hard again.
Play even harder.
So we're gonna make our way to Brian. So Brian, I know it ain't the shot, but how's your cat?
You put gas in that car, it's gonna ride.
Oh my God!
And that will conclude our interview with the FGC basketball team.